So this morning, I was, as usual, a little reluctant to do my morning squat because I've got some important work to do. But I always have some important work to do. This helps me just settle in at the beginning of the squat, especially if I'm a little tight, because it gives me a counterbalance. It's 2 kilograms. Also, because I'm not staring at the floor and trying to engage the camera, it means I get pushed back, which is not a bad thing to work on, but this is not a strong position. This is a position to be relaxed in. So the key to sustaining a squat like this over time is working out how to do it in such a way that you're actually relaxed, that the muscles running through your shins and your feet are not overly active. So at the moment, there's quite a bit going on through here. And through here, as I'm pulling forward, that's better. So breathing counts for a lot, although if that comes as a surprise to you, you've got a long way to go. The reason I've got a drink here is twofold. One, I like having boiled water with lemon, or in this case, lime, in the morning. And two, it's a large mug. And I say to myself, I'm not getting up until I finish this mug. It's very hot, so I can't really gulp it all down. But it's fairly comfortable here. So I want to talk about the FAI fix. So the FAI Fix is a program available online for, all things considered, a pretty reasonable price. That helps people who are diagnosed with femoroacetabular impingement. Femoroacetabular impingement. Impingement is a condition diagnosed by doctors who identify that there is something going wrong in the abduction and adduction of the femur and internal and external rotation of the femur. So the femur is your thigh bone, and it plugs into the hip socket. So you have your thigh, at the top of your thigh bone is a ball, it's basically like a ball, and you have an good, and it fits in your hip socket. And when you move, moves within the hip socket and rotates within the hip socket. Femoroacetabular impingement is a name that correctly identifies that there is an impingement, but doesn't really explain why there be such an impingement. The orthodoxy, medical orthodoxy, says that it's purely bone, that you that there is simply not enough clearance between your between the lip of your acetabulum, your hip socket, and your thigh bone. And so the solution is to surgically shave down the top of the thigh bone in order to give it more space. And it is as expensive and painful as one can imagine. So I was diagnosed with femoroacetabular impingement, even though I had a reasonably good range of motion for quite a while, for most of my life. But I started getting pain in my hip. It was a kind of burning sensation, a perennial pain. So I went to the doctor and I was referred to, I had an x-ray, and then the x-ray to an ultrasound, and an ultrasound to an MRI. And the answer came back that I had this, that there was irritation of the hip socket. The diagnosis was femoroacetabular impingement. The recommendation was surgery. So I went online and I discovered a program that promised to, at the very least, address the problem, if not cure the ailment. The program was called the FAI Fix, and it simply put, it prescribes three things: very intense tissue work being self-massage, usually by means of some implement, stretching, and stretching precisely of the areas that you don't like stretching, and then muscle activation to reactivate the muscles pertaining to the function of the hip, to the movement of the hip. I purchased access to the program, and for 3 months I checked myself into a CrossFit box, and that's what I did. Lots and lots of tissue work, lots and lots of stretching, lots and lots of muscle activation. Not exciting, not pretty. You're not going to get the goals, my friend, by doing these stretches that don't look like you're stretching very much, but you feel that you're stretching a lot. So I did that for 3 months. About an average of an hour, between one and a half to 2 hours a day, 5 days a week. That was 2015 that I did that. 2015. And here I am. The problem went away. And the thing is that I was so focused on following the program that I actually can't tell you when I stopped getting hip pain. It just went away. And it's not that it comes back and that I have to address it. It's just that it's a thing of the past. I follow the program to the letter. So I can definitely say that it works. And I'm making this video as a demonstration of the hypnobility available if you follow the program. I've been on this journey towards being more flexible and more grounded for quite a while, a good few years now. And one of the things I recognized was that in Western society we spend an enormous amount of time, really all of our time, sitting. We walk around maybe, we go to the gym, but we don't really spend enough time squatting. And I think that there's a pervading belief that it's only Asians, maybe Africans as well, it's only people from, at least from third world countries, who can squat like this for as long as this video has been going on. I can't see on the camera how long, but it's not unusual for me to be down here for 15 minutes, and I've been even longer, 20 minutes. But it's simply a matter of conditioning. A few years ago, I could not squat. There is no way I could get into this position. Not with any weights, not with any counterbalance, nothing. I simply didn't have the range of motion in my ankles to permit this position. And so most people who try to do this simply fall backwards. If they get down here at all, they certainly can't sustain it because all their weight is already in their heels, whereas my weight is fairly comfortably driving through the center of my foot. And as far as hip flexion goes, well, you don't get much more hip flexion than this. My knees are pushing up into my armpits, and I'm folded right over. And when I finish the drink, I'll demonstrate the full hip flexion. Hip extension, well, everyone can do that. Internal rotation, external rotation, those are pretty good by me. I'm working to get wider and wider, one day to get down to the splits. But a lot of things have to work out for me before I can do that. Nevertheless, it's working well for me. Right, drink's finished, and I'm feeling pretty comfortable. So, what do I think of the FAI fix? Quite simply, it works, and I think it works for most people. In fact, it would only be a very unusual case that it wouldn't work for. But the caveat is that you have to follow the program. This isn't something that you supplement your workout with. If you have femoral acetabular impingement, which is, in my opinion, something of a made-up disease, but it's nevertheless a useful term for people whose hip function, whose hips are dysfunctional, or rather, whose movement patterns and muscle activation sequences are dysfunctional, giving rise to pain in the hip. This position should not be unusual. This position does not require anything physiologically unusual. Everyone should be able to do it. Everyone should be able to do it comfortably. Not just Asians, certain Africans, and Eastern Europeans who like sitting on the street. So there really, I don't suppose I can be the greatest salesman for the program. Not that that's my intention, of course. I just wanted to talk about, I wanted to show more than say what it is that's, you know, that's so good about it. So I'll talk a bit more about squatting. So what I'm doing here is I'm trying to make sure that my feet are pretty much straight forward, rather than turned out. Because in this position, you get that, first of all, you get the full hip flexion. And you really fold it over, so you can even wrap your arms around your knees and give a little pull with your upper body. It's really great for the lower back. It's really the equivalent of lying on the floor and letting your back relax, because you're letting gravity just work on your lower back, and you're also getting stronger. And there's something I think that we need as humans. There's something that we need that resides in this position of deep flexion. All right, so I'll take my feet in all the way. So the ultimate in squatting, sort of the ultimate position, is where everything's brought together. When people squat in the gym, it's usually a little wider than about shoulder width, so wider than the hip width, which really necessitates your feet to turn out a bit, unless you're consciously externally rotating, which means you've got to really work your thighs and your external hip rotators. And so it's not a relaxed position. So for it to be a relaxed position, you basically have to have everything in line. And then to kind of achieve that milestone, it's helpful to also practice having your feet and your shins and your thighs not merely in line with your hips, but actually even narrower. So again, that's not a relaxed position because you're not in a straight line, bearing down from the hips through the legs, through the feet, but it is a good thing to practice. And it makes it easier to then relax in what should be the standard position, which is this. So let me demonstrate. Bring my feet. So go to the heels to allow the front, go to the front to allow the back to move until these are together. And then these I just squeeze together. There's not a lot of room to breathe. So you're all sort of squashed up. But this is a nice stretch for the glutes actually, and the lower back. So wrap one arm around the knees and another around the shins. And there you go. And now this is even a little easier. But I've been down here for long enough, I suppose. So I'm going to leave it at that. Let's see what people make of it.
Anyway, thanks for watching.